Hi everyone, myself Vamsi Krishna. As a part of our end-to-end scenario of loading S3 data to RDS, we are going to focus on connecting to RDS using Lambda function. For that, I already created a Lambda role for connecting to RDS. Let me show you that role. This is the role which I created. And this Lambda role for application one for S3 CloudWatch has Amazon RDS full access, Amazon S3 full access, and CloudWatch full access. Now I'm going to create Lambda function using this particular IAM role. And inside that Lambda function, I'm going to use MySQL modules and test the connection to RDS. Go to function, create a function, and write the function name. Write, or you can say function as connect to RDS using Python. Okay, I have written connect to RDS using Python. In the runtime, select Python 3.8. Under the permission, use an existing role and select the role which I just showed sometime before. Click on create function. Our function is created and we need to write the code to connect to the connect our Lambda function to MySQL. Let me import the statements. These are the statements which we need to import for connecting to MySQL. And here we need to write, as per this diagram whatever I explained in the earlier session, we need to write mysql.connector.connect. We need to write mysql.connector.connect so that we can create a connection object. I'm going to select this particular line and paste it here. Align this in single line to whatever extent it is possible. Or else this is fine. Click on save. We are trying to connect to that. And once we are able to establish the connection, then we are going to create a cursor. We are going to create a cursor and then we are going to insert these records. Let me copy this as well. This is the query which we are going to use. MySQL employee insert query, insert into employee. These are the columns and this is how we are going to insert. These are the rows. For timing I'm hard coding, but as a part of our end to end, we already have a Lambda function where I read it from S3. I'm going to replace that logic. Scroll down and just write this logic and let me explain this. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to create a connection. Once connection is created, I'm going to write the query and I'm going to select the rows and I'm going to create cursor object and then I'm going to execute many method with the query and the rows. And then I'm using commit so that my data will be saved. And then I'm printing how many records got successfully inserted. Click on save. Now create a test event. I will say MySQL test event. MySQL test event one and just click on create. Fine. Now we have the test event. Click on test. Fine. Now if you see, we are facing one issue. Let me read out the issue. Now the error is no module named MySQL, meaning whatever the code we have written in the earlier session, if you run that code as it is in Lambda function, it is not working out. Why? Because there is no module named MySQL and Lambda function is not able to identify your MySQL module. This is the reason Lambda has come up with a concept called layers concept. This is the Lambda layers concept, which we discussed in the our introduction session. Now, this Lambda layer is nothing but a zip archive that contains the libraries. In this case, we can create a Lambda layer for MySQL connector, and this will contain MySQL connector layers. And now, what we need to do is, before we get started, it is very important to understand that when a layer zip is archive is loaded into AWS Lambda, it is unzipped into this particular folder. In case of Python 3.8, it is going to unzip into this particular folder. For your Python Lambda function to import the libraries contained in the layer, the library should be placed under Python subdirectory of the this particular folder. Meaning, whatever the module you are going to use, you need to install that particular module in this folder. And whenever you want to create a zip, you need to go to Python folder and you should create a zip out of that. Okay, let me create a directory like this, and then I'm going to install MySQL connector into that package, and then I'm going to go into the build directory. I will have the Python folder, and I'm going to use zip-r if it is a Linux machine, and I'm going to use Windows if it is a Windows machine. I will directly extract it. Okay, let us go to this Visual Studio. Now, what I need to do is, I am there in Python Kinesis demo directory. Let me create a folder, mkdir-p, and this is the folder which we need to create. This is the folder structure which we need to create. Copy this folder structure. Okay, mkdir, this is the folder structure. The syntax is incorrect. Okay, fine. This is like Linux path. Let me do one thing. I'm going to one folder in my system. Let me go to H folder. This is my Cloud Tech Masters. I already have AWS Lambda layer demo folder. Let me delete this and recreate it again. This is that folder. It's already open. Let me delete it again. Perfect. Now, I'm going to create a folder. Git bash I'll use. Mkdir. I'll say AWS Lambda layer Python. Go into AWS Lambda layer Python, and here you need to create a folder structure of this. Copy this and create a folder with this name, mkdir-p. The structure is build /python/lib/python 3.8, because my Lambda function runtime is Python 3.8 site-packages. Now, for this folder, I'm going to install MySQL connector package for which Lambda function is failing. Let us install pip install mysql-connector, and then you need to install this into target directory -t. Target directory is this one. Now let the pip install to the corresponding target directory. Perfect. Now our MySQL connector package was installed, and as per this, for our Python Lambda function to import the libraries contained in the layer, the library should be placed under Python subdirectory. We need to go to this particular folder which we created, and we need to go to build Python subdirectory, and inside this Python subdirectory we need to use 7zip or some other tool to create a Python zip. You should not create outside zip. You should not create zip from build folder. You need to create zip from Python folder only. If you create it from build folder, when this gets unzipped, it will go in wrong path and it will not work. While you are extracting the zip or while you are creating a zip file, make sure you create zip out of Python folder. Now, next thing what we need to do is, whatever the zip we created, we need to upload this zip file to create it as a Lambda layer. Let us go to Lambda function. This is our Lambda function. Click on functions and click on Lambda. And here we have layer. We need to create a layer. And layer name is MySQL Lambda layer. Layer name is MySQL Lambda layer Python. MySQL Lambda layer Python. Description also I'll keep the same. And if you have a zip file, you can upload the zip file directly. And if your zip file is larger than 10 MB, you can upload the file to S3 and you can take it from there. I'm uploading the zip file. Click on upload and H Cloud Tech Master. This is my folder, AWS Lambda layer Python build. This is the zip file. Perfect. This is not even 1 MB. I'm going to upload this and runtime is Python 3.8. And click on create. I have created the Lambda layer. Now I need to add this Lambda layer to the existing Lambda function. Go to Lambda function and connect to RDS using Python. And inside this Lambda function, you have an option called layers. Click on layers and you add the layer. Click on layers. Click on add a layer. And this is custom layer. Select custom layer. And our layer is MySQL Lambda layer Python version is 1. Click on add. Now I have added the layer. Before running this Lambda function, make sure what is the data you are going to insert. I'm going to insert 300, 400. This is just for my identification. I'm going to insert employee ID with 300, employee ID with 400, so that whatever the data I have, I'll not get confused. I have only two records. When I run this Lambda function, it is going to insert 300 or 400 as well, because we added the Lambda layer. Click on save and click on test. Now we can see the execution. Execution result is succeeded. Perfect. There is no exception coming in now, because whatever the layer we added, it is success and it is able to connect to RDS and it persisted the data also in RDS. Let us cross verify here. Select it. Perfect. 300, 400. Perfect. Our Lambda layer creation is correct and we are able to connect to RDS using Lambda function. And in the next video, I'm going to read the file from S3 and I'm going to use this layer and I'm going to change the logic slightly in the existing Lambda function itself, so that whenever a file comes from S3, we are going to insert into RDS by reading the file. Thanks everyone for watching this video.